Okay, so we'll start with the next problem, that is problem number 2 on flat slab. The problem statement is design an interior panel of flat slab with following data. Size of floor is 18 by 18 meters, panel size is 66 meter by 6 meter. The flat slab is supported by column size 500 mm by 500 mm, provides suitable drops. So we have to provide drop in this particular type of flat slab. In the previous problem, we have designed a flat slab without any type of drops. Okay, and then take live load as 4 kilonewton per square meter, and use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. If any additional data is required, you can assume it can be assumed at your level. Okay. Also, if you are not given these data, that is grade of concrete, grade of steel, then you have to assume this particular data also. If this live load is not given, again you have to assume this particular live load also. Okay, you can calculate the live load, or you can determine the live load from IS 875. Okay, so we'll start designing this particular flat slab. So this is our problem statement. We have to design this interior panel having size 6 meter by 6 meter. This panel is supported on columns of 500 mm by 500 mm, that is square column, and it is provided with some sort of drop. Okay, live load is given as 4 kilonewton per square meter, and we have to use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. Okay, now what we have already seen, what is a drop? If a flat slab is provided like this, that is a flat slab is a slab which is having no beams. Okay, so this is called this is your slab, this portion is your slab, and this is your column, this is your column. So this type of flat slab is called as your flat plate. It is called as flat plate. Okay, so flat slab is a slab which is not provided with any type of beams. Okay, whereas if no drops or column heads are provided, then it is called as a flat plate. Now the second type of flat slab is like this. If you are providing a flat slab, and then near your column, if you are increasing the thickness of that particular slab, okay, if this thickness, we are increasing this much thickness, okay, so then this particular portion is called as a drop. This particular portion is called as a drop. So in this particular type of problem, we are designing a flat slab with drop. We are designing the flat slab with drop. The advantage of providing this type of drops is it increases the shear strength of your flat slab. At the same time, it increases the negative bending moment carrying capacity of your slab. Okay, so we'll start designing this particular flat slab. Okay, so this is how the flat slab is given. That is, the total size of your flat slab is 18 meter, or your floor size is 18 meter by 18 meter, 18 meter by 18 meter. You can consider here 18 meter by 18 meter like this. Okay, whereas you have divided this particular floor into number of panels. The size of these panels is 6 meter by 6 meter. The size of this panels is 6 meter by 6 meter. So each panel is 6 meter by 6 meter like this. Okay, okay, and you have to design this interior panel. We have to design this interior panel. So this panel is having panels on all the directions. Okay, it is having panels on the all the direction, therefore it is called as an interior panel. So we have to design this particular interior panel. Okay, so we'll start the design. Okay, at the same time you should also keep in mind that size of column is also given here. The size of column is given as 500 by 500 mm. That is, the column is a square column. So every column is having dimension 500 mm by 500 mm. So it is a square column. Okay. So given data. We'll start with the given data. So given data is So we are given with floor size is given as 18 meter by 18 meter. Okay, size of panel is given as 6 meter by 6 meter. Okay, column size is given as 500 mm by 500 mm. Then live load on flat slab it is given as 4 kilonewton per meter square. Then we have grade of concrete is given as M20. Therefore we can take this FCK. Therefore FCK is equal to 20 newton per mm square. Okay. Next we have steel. We have steel Fe415. Therefore we can take the strength of steel Fy is equal to 415 newton per mm square. Okay. Now step number one. We'll start with the step number one. This is what we have. Okay, and we'll start with the step number one is calculation of depth of your slab. So calculation of depth of slab. Calculation of depth of slab. This is our first step. So we know that for continuous slabs or beams, okay, we have this ratio span upon depth. This is given as 26 multiplied by multiplication factor MF. This is as per IS 456. It is as per IS 456 clause number 23.2.1. It is given at page number 37. It is given as page number 37. Now we have to find out the value of this multiplication factor. Let us assume the tension reinforcement provided is equal to 0.4%. Let us assume that we are providing tension reinforcement as 0.4%. Therefore multiplication factor, this can be obtained from IS 456. Go to page number 38. This graph is given here. We have for Fe415 this value fs, okay, or this value fs can be calculated by multiplying this Fe415, that is 415, with 0.58 multiplied by fy. So we can get this value fs, which is given here only. The fs is equal to 0.58 fy. So we can calculate this fs. If we multiply this 0.58 multiplied by fy, that is for 415, we have 415. So we get it is approximately 240. So we have to use this second curve for calculation of this value of multiplication factor. Now we are assuming that the percentage of steel provided is 0.4. Therefore the value of modification factor will be in between 1.2 and 1.4 here. So let us assume that the modification factor is considered as 1.3. So we'll directly take this value as 1.3 for 0.4% AST. So we get this multiplication factor. It is a multiplication factor. We consider this as 1.3. Therefore, span upon depth. Therefore, this ratio span upon depth. This is equal to we have a span of 6000 mm. 6000 mm divided by depth. We have to calculate this, and it is given by this formula, which is given here. That is 26 multiplied by multiplication factor. We have calculated the value of multiplication factor as 1.3, therefore 1.3. So we get this value of D. Just calculate the value of D. We get the value of D is equal to 177.51 mm. Let us provide this value D is equal to 190 mm. Let us provide this value D is equal to 190 mm. You should not provide this value of D less than 177.51 mm. We are providing that 190 mm. Therefore, if we provide a cover of 30 mm, if we provide cover of 30 mm, then total depth D, this will be equal to effective depth plus cover. So this is equal to 190 plus 30, that is equal to 220 mm. Okay, so 220 mm, this is our total depth of your flat slab. This is the total depth of your flat slab. But as per your clause of IS 456, which states that the thickness of your slab should not be less than 125 mm. The minimum thickness of flat slab is 125 mm. Therefore, as per this particular clause of IS 456, this is more than 125 mm. Therefore, it is more than 125 mm. Hence it is okay. So we'll be providing total depth is equal to 220 mm. Okay. Now let us provide. Now in this particular problem, we have to provide a drop also. So let us provide. Thickness of drop. Thickness of drop is equal to 50 mm. We are assuming that the thickness of drop is 50 mm. Therefore, at the column head, the total depth will be the depth of your slab plus depth of your drop. Okay, so at column head, D will be equal to this 220 plus 50 minus clear cover, that is 30 mm. So this is equal to we get this as 240 mm. The formula can be written as this: D plus thickness of drop minus clear cover. So this is equal to 240 mm, which is at the column head. That is, if this is your flat slab, what we are doing, we are just increasing the thickness of flat slab near the column. So this particular portion, this is called as your drop. So we are just increasing this particular thickness of flat slab at the column connection between your flat slab and your column. So we got the effective depth as 240 mm at the column head, and total depth D is equal to 220 mm plus thickness of your flat slab. So this is equal to 270 mm. So total depth at the drop will be equal to 270 mm. Now we have to find out the size of drop. So size of drop. Okay. So size of drop. Okay. So as per IS 456. As per this particular clause of IS 456, Okay, the drop when provided shall be rectangular in plan and have a length in each direction not less than 1/3 of the panel length in that particular direction. 1/3 of panel length in that particular direction. So we have to provide the dimension of your drop as per this particular clause 31.2.2 of IS 456. So we'll specify the dimensions. It should not be less than 1/3 of your panel dimension. It should not be less than 1/3 of your panel dimension. Okay, so size of drop. It should not be less than 1/3 of your panel direction dimension. So 1/3 × 6 is equal to 2 meter. Okay, so panel the size of your drop panel comes out to be 2 meter by 2 meter because it is a square panel. Therefore, the size of drop panel will be 2 meter by 2 meter. And let us provide 3 meter by 3 meter size of drop panel. Okay, as per IS 456, the size of drop panel should not be less than 1/3 of your panel dimension. 1/3 of your panel dimension in that particular direction. So we are providing a drop panel of 3 by 3 meter. Okay. Therefore we get width of column strip is equal to width of your middle strip. This is equal to 3000 mm or 3 meter. Why? Because if this is your flat slab, if we are specifying that the width of your drop panel is like this here, okay, the width of drop panel is 3 by 3 meter like this. Okay, we are having this drop panel 3 by 3 meter, then remaining portion will be 3 meter only. Okay, because 1.5 from this direction is covered by your drop panel and 1.5 from this direction. Therefore, middle strip will be 3 meter. Okay, obviously the panel dimension is 6 meter by 6 meter. Therefore, the width of your column strip will also be 3 meter only. Okay, so therefore width of middle strip is equal to width of your column strip is equal to 3 meter. At the same time, we should also keep in mind that this width of your column strip, this should not be less than 0.25 L1. Okay, so here 0.25 L1 comes out to be 0.25 into we have L1 is equal to 6 meter. Okay, sorry, this multiplied by 2. This is multiplied by 2. Okay, so this is multiplied by 2. So multiply by 2. So this comes out to be 3 meters. So it is okay. So we are providing the width of column strip is equal to width of middle strip is equal to 3000 mm or 3 meter. Now next step number 2 is load calculation. So step 2 is load calculation. Okay, so for design purpose let us take the width of your flat slab. Thickness of your flat slab at the drop panel. So at the drop panel, we know that if this is your flat slab, then at the drop panel, what we are having? We are having this is your drop. Okay, at the drop panel, we are having this total depth. This total depth as 270 mm. We will be considering this 270 mm throughout for calculation of self weight because it will be safer. So, okay, therefore we will be considering this 270 mm for calculation of self weight. Therefore, for calculation of your load calculation, we get this self weight of your flat slab. This will be equal to 0.27, that is 270 mm multiplied by 1 by 1 panel size multiplied by the weight density of your concrete, that is 25 kilonewton per cubic meter. So this comes out, so this comes out to be 6.75 kilonewton per meter square, 6.75 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, now assume floor finish is equal to floor finish. Okay, this value is not given in the problem, but therefore we have to assume this floor finish. This is the self weight of your tile works or any other type of flooring provided. So let us assume this is equal to 1 kilonewton per meter square. This is equal to 1 kilonewton per meter square. You can get this value of floor finish from IS 875. Now live load is given as live load on flat slab, this is given as 4 kilonewton per meter square, 4 kilonewton per meter square. Therefore total load will be equal to, that is just sum all these three loads, so we'll get this as 11.75 kilonewton per meter square, 11.75 kilonewton per meter square. So this is the total unfactored load, therefore we have to convert this into factored load. Okay, how it is done? It is done by multiplying the unfactored load with 1.5 or factor of safety. So 1.5 into 11.75, this is your factor of safety, so this comes out to be 17.625 kilonewton per meter square. So this is the factored load which is acting on your flat slab. Now assume that, we will be assuming in this particular problem that correction for pattern loading are not required. Therefore calculation of your stiffness of slab and columns and calculation of alpha c values will also not be required. Assuming that correction for pattern loading is not required. Okay, we are assuming that actually I have made this calculation and this comes out to be that corrections for pattern loading are not required for this particular type of for this particular problem. Okay, so now we'll go to step number three. Okay, so step number three is calculation of total design moment acting on the flat slab. So total design moment on flat slab or total design bending moment on the flat slab. We have to calculate this value. Now we know that the panel's dimension is given as, panel size is equal to 6 meter by 6 meter, and as per this IS 456, page number 55 and clause number 31.4.2.2, this clause, okay, the absolute sum of total positive and average negative bending moment in each direction shall be taken as M0 is equal to capital W ln divided by 8. So this is the formula for calculating the total design moment acting on your flat slab. So we'll use this particular formula. Now we know that this M0, that is total design moment, that is sum of positive and negative bending moment, is given as, is this value M0 is given as W, capital W ln divided by 8. This is the formula, but where we have this ln, this is the distance between the columns. So now we know that this is our panel, hemming dimension 6 meter by 6 meter, and these are our columns. These are our columns. The size of your our columns is 500 mm by 500 mm, whereas this total distance is 6000 mm or 6 meter. This is 6000 mm or 600 mm. Therefore, this will be 5500 mm. Okay, why 5500 mm? 0.25 from this direction is reduced, and 0.25 from this direction is reduced. Therefore, the clear span between the two columns will be 5500 mm. So this will be 6000 minus 0.5, that is your column size, divided by 2 minus 0.5 divided by again 2. So this comes out to be 5.5 meter. So this is our value of ln, whereas we know that the design load, okay, this value of W, capital W, it is given by your factored load W multiplied by L2, that is the direction in up in which you are not calculating the bending moment, L2 multiplied by ln. So this particular formula can be modified like this: M0 is equal to W, just put the value of this capital W here in this particular equation, so we get this as LW into L2 into ln square divided by 8 divided by 8. So this is our formula for calculation of design moment, total design moment. So this this will be equal to, we have W already calculated, that is factored load 17.625 multiplied by 6 into 5.5 square divided by 8. So total design moment, this comes out to be 399.87 kilonewton meter. Okay, though, so the value of this M0 comes out to be this much. Let us assume this M0 is equal to, is nearly equal to 400 kilonewton meter. Okay, this is as per, again we can write here as per this particular clause. This clause is 31.4.2.2. Okay, so we can write here as per IS 456 31.4.3.2. Okay, so this is how the total design moment is calculated. Now we have to distribute this or divide this total design moment into positive bending moment and negative bending moment. Or positive bending moment, positive moment and negative moment. Now as per IS 456 clause number 31.4.3.2, so we have to go downward, I think, just a minute, 31.4.3.2, okay, it is given here. Okay, in an interior panel, the total design moment M0 shall be distributed among the following proportion, that is negative bending design moment, this should be 0.65 of total design moment. Negative design moment shall be 0.65 of total design moment. So just 0.65. okay, so negative moment is 0.65 of total design moment. So this comes out to be, so this will be equal to 0.65 multiplied by 400 kilonewton meter. This value 400 kilonewton meter, so this comes out to be 260 kilonewton meter. Whereas the second clause states that the positive bending, second part of your this clause states that positive design moment shall be 0.35 of your total design moment. We have total design moment as 400, therefore this positive bending moment will be 0.35 into 400. So this comes out to be 140 kilonewton meter. This is as per IS 456 clause number 31.4.3.2. okay, so we have just distributed this divided this total design moment M0 in positive and negative bending moment. We got the positive, total positive bending moment as 140 kilonewton meter, whereas the total negative bending moment, this comes out to be 260 kilonewton meter. Now what we have to do, we have to divide this positive and negative bending moment among the column strips and middle strip. We know that what we have done, if this is your one panel dimension, or this is your one panel, if this is your one panel and this is your column, this is your column, this is your column, okay, this is plan dimension, okay, so this is your column, this will be your this blue portion, this will be your drop panel, this will be your drop, this will be your drop, okay, this will be your drop, this is your drop, again this blue portion, this is your drop. Now for design purpose, what we are doing, we are assuming that the we are dividing this particular flat slab into number of strips. So two types of strips are there. This first is column strips. So this is your column strip, so you can consider this column strip. So what this column strip is doing, this will transfer the forces from the middle strip to the your columns, from middle strip to the your column. So middle loads from the middle strip will be transferred to the column strip, and column strip will transfer the load to the columns. So this is one column strip, this is your second column strip, this is your second column strip, okay, along this direction, along, if we are considering along this direction, this is your first column strip and this is your second column strip, this is your second column strip. Whereas remaining portion, this remaining portion, or I'll change the color, okay, this remaining portion, this is called as your middle strip, this is called as your middle strip. So we are dividing this into column strip and middle strip. Again, in other direction, what we'll be doing, in other direction also we'll be dividing this column strip, this panel, into column strip and middle strip. Again, column strip and middle strip, this is your column strip again, and this is your second column strip, whereas the remaining portion, this remaining portion is your middle strip. So what will be happening is that, if we consider this column strip at the supports, here negative bending moment will be developed, whereas at the support negative bending moment is developed, and at the at central span or mid span, there will be some positive bending moment, there will be some positive bending moment. At the same time, if you see this middle strip, here we can see at the connection between your middle strip, at the connection between middle strip and your column strips, there will be negative bending moment, and at the central span or mid span, there will be positive bending moment. So this is why we are dividing this middle strip and column strip, so that we should be able to provide necessary steel reinforcement. Will be this it will be easier for us. So what we have to do, we have to divide this negative bending moment, and positive bending moment amongst the your column strip and middle strip. So amongst the middle strip and the column strip. Okay, so how we divide this now? Now we can write that, now we have to divide, we have to distribute or divide, distribute these moments into column strip and middle strip, okay. So we can do this in tabular format. Just write down here negative bending moment, your positive bending moment, okay. In next column, write down column strip, and in the next column, write down middle strip. Okay, just make some columns like this. Okay, so we'll be making some columns like this. ओके. नाउ एज पर IS 456 क्लॉज नंबर 31.5 पॉइंट, ओके इट इज गिवन हियर एज पर IS 456 क्लॉज नंबर 31.5.5.1 will be given somewhere here, that, yeah. So for column strip, we can see here, for column strip, negative moment at an interior support, okay, this shall be designed to resist 75% of the total negative bending moment. So we have to consider 0.75 or 75% of the total negative bending moment, so 0.7, write down here 0.75 multiplied by total negative bending moment. Total negative bending moment, we have already calculated that as 260. kN·m. So here we can write down 0.75 into 260. So this comes out to be 195 kilonewton meter, whereas remaining portion of your negative bending moment will be transferred to your middle strip. So remaining portion is 0.25 multiplied by 260. So this comes out to be 65 kilonewton meter. Whereas out of this positive bending moment, if you see this clause number 31.5.5.3, you can see here the 60% of total positive moment in the panel is given in the column strip, is contributed by the column strip. That is, the column strip is designed for 60%. Column is designed for 60% of the total positive moment. So what we'll be doing, we'll distribute out of total positive bending moment, we'll distribute 60% or 0.6 of total positive bending moment to the column strip. So we have total positive bending moment as 140 kilonewton meter. Out of this, 60% will be contributed by or taken by the column strip. So here we can write 140, so this is equal to 84 kilonewton meter, whereas remaining, that is 40% or 0.4 multiplied by 140, this comes out to be 56. This is taken by the middle strip, so this is 56 kilonewton meter. Here we can write down C clause number 31.5.1 and clause number 31.5.5.3 of IS 456. Okay. Now also we know that we have already calculated the width of your middle strip and width of column strip. So we have width of column strip is equal to width of middle strip is equal to 3000 mm. This is already calculated. Now we have to check for bending moment. So check for depth of slab or flat slab from bending moment consideration. Okay, we have two methods. The first method is just calculate D from this value, that is mu divided by Ru limiting into B. Otherwise, we can also compare this with the limiting bending moment. So, we'll calculate here limiting bending moment. We know that mu limiting, the formula for calculating mu limiting or limiting bending moment, this is given by mu limiting is equal to 0.138 fck bd square. We can put the value 0.138. we have fck m 20, therefore 20 b, we know that the width of your middle strip is 3000 mm, middle strip sorry your column strip is 3000 mm, and the thickness here, okay, we'll consider the thickness at the drop panel. So effective thickness at the drop panel is 240 mm, so square, so it this comes out to be 476.93 kilonewton meter, 93 kilonewton meter. Thus we can say that this value mu, that is equal to 400 kilonewton meter, we already calculated here in previous step. You can see here we have calculated this m0 value 400 kilonewton meter. This value is less than this mu, this value is less than mu limiting. This mu limiting is 476.93 kilonewton meter, and hence so your depth is sufficient from bending moment consideration. You can use this formula also. You can calculate the value of ru limiting. The value of ru limiting can be calculated by 0.1. we have ru limiting is equal to 0.138 into fck. For m20 we get fck is equal to 0.138 into 20. So whatever value you will get, I think it is 2.76. I am not sure about this. You can calculate, you can just do the calculation. Okay, calculate the value of ru limiting, put here value of b, and put here value of mu, that is equal to 400 kilonewton meter. You will get the required depth. If this required depth is less less than your depth provided, then it is okay. Now step number 4, now we'll go to step number 4. Step number 3, we have calculated the bending moments. Okay, now step number 4 is check for two way shear. Okay, these flat slab are always two way slab. These flat slabs are always two way slabs. Now we know that the critical section for two way shear is at a distance d by 2. Okay, this critical section is equal to d by 2 from face of columns. Okay, so this d by 2 is equal to, we have small d value as 240 mm at the drop panel. So write down here 240 mm divided by 2. Why we are considering at the drop panel? Because we will be considering the critical section near the columns, and at the critical section effective depth will be 240 mm, that is the effective depth at the drop panel. So this critical section width of your critical section, or this critical section, will be at a distance 240 by 2, that is 120 mm from face of the column. So we have the column dimension as 500 mm by 500 mm, whereas you can write here 500 mm by 500 mm. Okay, these dimensions are 500 by mm by 500 mm, whereas if we see the critical section is at a distance d by 2, that is d by 2 we have calculated as 120 mm. So this is 120, this is 500, width of your column, and again this is 120, that is width of your critical section or distance of critical section. Again in this direction we get this as 120, we get this as 500 mm, and last we get this as 120 mm. So this total width will be equal to sum of this plus this plus this. Okay, so this comes out to be 740 mm. Okay, so and in this direction also, as this is a square column, therefore this will be 740 mm only. Okay, now we know that, so this is the critical section, this is your critical section, this is your, sorry, this portion shown by your green line or previous blue line, this is your critical section. Now we have to calculate the shear strength of your flat slab. So we know that the shear force, okay, Vu is given by, the formula is total load on panel minus load on this 0.754 by 0.74 area, this 0.74 by 0.74 area, okay, on 0.74 by 0.74 area, okay. So put the values. We have total load on panel, that is 6 by 6 multiplied by total load, that is, this is the area, multiplied by total load, that is factored load, we have already calculated 17.625, minus load on this 0.74 by 0.74, multiplied with the 17.625. So you will get the value of your shear force, that is Vu. This Vu comes out to be 624.85 kilonewton meter. Vu comes out to be this much, sorry, kilonewton, only kilonewton. Okay, Vu comes out to be this much. Now B0, that is the perimeter of this particular critical section, that is the total length of this green line, the total length of this blue or green line, this will be equal to this 740, this 740 plus this 740 plus this 740 plus this 740, okay. So that is 740 multiplied by 4, 740 multiplied by 4. So this B0 comes out to be 4 multiplied by 740 mm. So this comes out to be 2.96 meter, this comes out to be 2.96 meter, and it is the perimeter of total critical section, okay. Now we have to find out the nominal shear, that is value of tau V, that is equal to nominal shear. We have to find out nominal shear, okay. Now we have tau C is equal to Vu upon B0 into D. We have already calculated Vu, that is 624.85, convert it into Newton, so 10 raised to power 3 divided by B0 is 2960, and depth is 240 mm. Why 240 mm? Because we are considering the depth at the drop panel, therefore we get this value of tau V is equal to 0.88 newton per mm square. Now next we have to check whether this value tau V is greater than or less than tau C dash, okay. Now we know that this value tau C dash, is given as, that is shear strength, this is given as Ks multiplied by tau C, where this value Ks, this is equal to beta C plus 1, where this value beta C is the ratio of shorter dimension of your column to the longer dimension of your column. So we have dimension of column as 0.5 by 0.5. Therefore, this comes out to be 1. Therefore, Ks comes out to be 1 plus 1. This is equal to 2. But the limitation on this value of Ks, it should not be greater than 1. Therefore, we get this value Ks is equal to 1. Okay. Now, we have to keep in mind that this tau C dash, that is shear strength, is equal to Ks into tau C. Okay. This is as per IS 456, page number 58. This is given at the page number 58. Okay. And again, at the same time, we know that this value of tau C is given as 0.25 under root FCK. It is as per IS 456, clause number sorry, clause given on page number, this is page number 59. This is given on the page number 59. You can also check. I think it will be given somewhere here. Yeah, this is the value given here. Okay, this shear strength is given by Ks into tau c, whereas the value of this tau c, the value of this tau c is given by this formula. It is given by this formula, that is tau c is equal to 0.25 into fck, 0.25 fck in limit state method, in limit state method. Okay, so we can calculate the value of tau c here. Tau, we get the value of tau c is equal to 0.25 under root fck. So this is equal to 0.25 under root fck is 20. So this comes out to be 1.12 newton per mm square, 1.12 newton per mm square. Okay, whereas this value tau c dash, that is shear strength, tau c or tau dash c, this is equal to ks into tau c, ks into tau c. We have ks is equal to 1 and tau c as 1.12, so this tau c dash comes out to be 1.12 newton per mm square, newton per mm square, newton per mm square. Okay, now this value tau dash c, this is greater than tau v, this is greater than tau v. We know that we have already calculated the value of tau v. Tau v comes out to be 0.88, which is shown here, 0.88, and tau c is 1.12. Okay, so this tau c dash, this is 1.12, and tau v, this is 0.88. therefore, okay, so from this calculation we can say that there are no shear reinforcement are required. This particular slab or flat slab is safe in shear. This is safe in shear. At the same time, what we can do additionally if required, if we are doing this in the field, then we can also take the check for shear at a distance small d by 2, at a distance small d by 2 from face of flat your drop panel, from face of drop panel. Okay, this can also be done, but we'll skip that. Okay, that is not required actually. If if you want more accuracy, you can do this, but actually it is not required, because your drop size is large, therefore this will be safe in shear also. Okay, now step number 5 is steel reinforcement calculation. Steel reinforcement, steel reinforcement calculation, steel reinforcement calculation. Okay, so next step is steel reinforcement calculation. So we have to calculate the steel reinforcement. Let us consider A for negative steel, or we can just, I'll just, okay, so for negative steel, we know that we have calculated the negative bending moment at the column strip. We calculated the negative bending moment as 195 kilonewton meter, 195 kilonewton meter. So we have to design for this 195 kilonewton meter, 195 kilonewton meter. Okay, so for negative steel, for negative steel, we have mu, that is bending moment, mu for column strip. Okay, for column strip, we have mu, that is already calculated as 195 kilonewton meter, 195 kilonewton meter. We have the formula AST for steel calculation. Generally use this formula. This is easier as compared with, I think some of the students are using some other formula. That is also correct, but this is more easier for calculation purpose. Okay, so AST is equal to 0.5 इंटू एफ सी के डिवाइडेड बाई एफ वाई, एफ सी के इंटू एफ डिवाइडेड बाई एफ वाई इंटू वन माइनस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस 4.6 mu अपॉन एफ सी के बी डी स्क्वायर क्लोज द ब्रैकेट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बी इंटू डी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बी इंटू डी. नाउ फॉर दिस कॉलम स्ट्रिप, नाउ फॉर कॉलम स्ट्रिप वी हैव द विड्थ ऑफ योर कॉलम स्ट्रिप बी, विड्थ ऑफ कॉलम स्ट्रिप बी इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच, द विड्थ ऑफ कॉलम स्ट्रिप इज इक्वल टू, विड्थ ऑफ कॉलम स्ट्रिप इज इक्वल टू 3000 mm, वेर एज द इफेक्टिव डेफ्थ डी इज 240 mm, इफेक्टिव डेफ्थ डी इज 240 mm. जस्ट पुट द वैल्यूज ऑफ डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स हियर, सो वी गेट दिस ए एस टी, वी गेट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ ए एस टी इज इक्वल टू 0.5 इंटू एफ सी के इज 20, एफ वाई इज 415 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 माइनस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 1 माइनस 4.6 इंटू एम यू. वी हैव एम यू ऑलरेडी, वी नो दैट इट इज 195 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10 टू पावर 6 कन्वर्टेड इट इंटू किलो न्यूटन एम एम डिवाइडेड बाय एफ सी के इज 20, बी इज 3000, अगेन डी स्क्वायर दैट इज 240 स्क्वायर and multiply this whole term with b into d, b is 3000 and d is 240. So just calculate the value of AST, this comes out to be 2420.33 mm square, 2420.33 mm square. okay, now we have to check whether this is more than AST minimum, therefore percentage AST is equal to AST divided by B into D. So we have AST is equal to 2420.33 divided by, we have B is equal to 3000 and depth as 270. So this comes out to be 0.3%. And this is more than 0.12%, which is required. Hence, okay. So we calculated this percentage AST. Let us provide. Now we'll provide 12 mm 5 bars. Therefore spacing is equal to S is equal to, now the spacing is given by area of 1 5 bar multiplied by width of your column strip divided by AST divided by AST. So it's equal to pi by 4 into 12 square into B is 3000 divided by AST is 2420.33. So this comes out to be 140.184 mm. Let us assume it is approximately equal to 140 mm center to center. So we will be providing 12 5 bar. So provide 12 5 bar at 140 mm center to center. Now let us consider B type reinforcement, that is for positive moment in column strip. AST for positive reinforcement. AST for positive reinforcement. Sorry, positive bending moment. Positive bending moment in column strip. Okay, so again we have mu. Okay, positive bending moment for column strip, we know that the positive bending moment for your column strip is given by this zero point, this value, that is 0.6 into 140, it is equal to 84 kilonewton meter. Okay, ओके सो mu इज इक्वल टू 84 किलो न्यूटन मीटर, 84 किलो न्यूटन मीटर, देयर फोर वी गेट दिस AST. अगेन विड्थ ऑफ योर कॉलम स्ट्रिप इज इक्वल टू 3000 mm एंड डेफ्थ, इफेक्टिव डेफ्थ इज इक्वल टू 200, सॉरी दिस इफेक्टिव डेप्थ, दिस इज फॉर द कॉलम स्ट्रिप एट द सेंट्रल पोर्शन और मिड स्पैन. सो इफेक्टिव डेप्थ एट द मिड स्पैन ऑफ योर कॉलम स्ट्रिप दिस विल बी 190 mm. Therefore, AST is equal to 0.5. I don't write the formula again here. 0.5 into FCK is 20. 20 multiplied by 415 multiplied by 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4.6 into MU. MU is here 84 kilo newton meter. So 84 into 10 raised to power 6, just converted it into newton mm, newton mm divided by FCK is 20 into B is 3000, D square that is 190 square, so multiplied by again B into D that is 3000 into 190, so this AST comes out to be 1285.22 mm square. Okay, so this is how much, this is the AST which is calculated. Now we have to check percentage AST. This is equal to, we know that AST divided by AST divided by B into D, B into D. So B is equal, AST is equal to 1285.22 divided by B is 3000 and D is here, D will be equal to 220 mm. So this comes out to be 0.19%. This is more than 0.12%. This is more than 0.12% is equal to AST minimum. This is AST minimum and hence okay. So third, now C. Now go for C that is for, okay sorry, we have to calculate the spacing. We have to also calculate the spacing. Okay, we have to calculate spacing. We get the spacing is equal to, let us provide 10 5 bar. Therefore area of 1 5 multiplied by B divided by AST provided. Okay, so this is equal to area of 1 5 bar for 10 5, that is 5 by 4 into 10 square multiplied by B is 3000 divided by AST provided is 1200, AST provided is 1285.22 mm square. So this spacing comes out to be 183.36 mm. Let us assume this is nearly equal to 180 mm. Therefore provide 10 5 bars at 180 mm center to center. Okay, we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next lecture.